Okay, so today we're going to be taking a look at collecting like terms. So if we look at this first example, we have simplify 5a plus 3b plus 2a plus 6b. So the question only says simplify, but we should know by looking at this question here, we have multiple terms of a, we have multiple terms of b. So this is an expression where we'd be able to combine those terms and make it into a more simplified expression. So let's start with the a's. What do we have? We have 5a plus 2a. So if we do that 5a, add another two lots of a, we should have 7a. And then we're going to look at our terms of b. So we have positive 3b, positive 6b. So we've got 3b plus another 6b. That'd give us nine lots of b. So at the end here, we'd have plus nine lots of b. Okay, for our next question, we're going to do exactly the same thing. We have 7c plus 2d minus 5c minus d. So again, let's look at our individual terms. Let's look for our terms of c. We have 7c, take away 5c. So if I have 7 lots of c and I take away 5c, that gives me 2 lots of c. Now let's move over to the terms of d. We have positive 2d, and we're going to take away a term of d. So if I have 2 lots of d and I take away a term of d, that's going to leave me with 1 term of d. So it's positive, so it'll be a plus, and I have 1d left over. We don't write the 1 in this case, we're just going to write plus d. Okay, looking at this next question, we have simplify 8x plus 3y plus 7x subtract 7y. So again, let's identify those terms of x. We have 8x plus 7x. Well, if I do 8x and I add another 7x, that should give me 15 lots of x. So 15x. And then our terms of y, we have positive 3y, but then we have negative 7y. So in this case, we've got 3y, positive 3y, and we've got to take away 7 lots of y. So 3 take away 7 is actually going to give us negative or minus 4 lots of y. So our final expression for that would be 15x take away 4y. Okay, for this next question, we have 3x minus 2y minus 5x plus 4y. So we've got, in terms of x, 3x take away 5 lots of x. So 3x take away 5x is actually negative 2 lots of x. And then for our terms of y, we have negative 2y, and we're going to add 4y. So if I do negative 2 and I add on 4, that actually gives me positive 2. So I would have plus 2 lots of y. What I can do with this one as well, just to make it look a bit neater, instead of having negative 2x plus 2y, I can flip them around. So that's the same as saying 2y take away 2x, just so that we don't have that negative at the beginning. It means exactly the same thing. Right, now we're going to take a look at some multiplication questions. So for this first one, I have 6 multiplied by 3b. So I'm going to write that out a bit fuller. So we have 6 multiplied by 3b actually means 3 multiplied by b. So now we can see we have our number terms, we have our terms of our letters as well. So let's combine what we can first. I have 6 multiplied by 3. 6 multiplied by 3 is 18. And then I've got, at the end, I've got my term of b. So I'm then multiplying by b. So I have my numbers combined, I have 18. And then I'm multiplying that by b. So my final answer would just be to hide that multiplication sign. So the final answer would be 18 lots of b. Okay, for the next question, we have 4c multiplied by 5d. So again, if I write this out in full, we have 4c, which means 4 multiplied by c. And then we're multiplying this by 5d, which in turn means 5 multiplied by d. So if we take our number terms, we have 4 multiplied by 5, which we know is 20. Then we're multiplying by our term of c here. So we're going to be multiplying this by c. And then finally, we have our term of d at the end. So we will then be multiplying by d. So we have our 20. We have our terms of c. We have our terms of d. There's nothing else we can do more with this. So all we're going to do is hide those multiplication signs. So my final answer would be 20cd. Okay, now let's look at some division questions. So for the first one, we have simplify 10a divided by 2. So what we're going to do for this one, we've got 10 lots of a, we're going to divide that by 2. So we do 10 divided by 2, which is our 5. So that's going to leave us with 5 lots of a. We can actually work this question back to front to check we've got the answer correct. So if I've just done divide by 2 to give me 5a, if I did that back to front, if I then took that 5a and multiplied it by 2, just like the questions we've done on the previous slide, we'd have 5 multiplied by 2 is 10, and then we put our a back. So 10a is back to what we started with. Okay, for our next question, we have 15x plus 25y all divided by 5. So we've got to take everything in the numerator and divide it by the denominator. We can actually write this out as the individual fractions because we have a common denominator of 5. So this is the same as saying 15x divided by 5 plus 25y divided by 5. So let's go through and do it. So we've got 15x divided by 5. So we do the 15 divided by 5 is 3. So there we have 3 lots of x. And then we have 25y divided by 5. So 25 divided by 5 is 5. So for here, we'd have plus 5 lots of y. And that's the answer to that one. Okay, for our next question, we have simplify 3xy plus 5xy minus 2xy. So we have at the beginning 3 lots of this term xy. Then we're going to add 5 lots of this term xy, so that's going to give us 8 lots of the term xy. But then we've got to then subtract 2 lots of xy. So if I do 8xy take away 2xy, that's going to leave me with 6 lots of the term xy. And that's our final answer. Okay, on to our final question for today. We have simplify 3x squared plus 5x plus 2x squared minus 2x plus 7. So if you have a quick look through this expression, we have terms of x squared, we have terms of x, then we have a constant term right at the end. So let's combine the like terms. We have 3x squared plus 2 lots of x squared. Well, that's just going to give us 5 lots of the term x squared. Then for our terms of x, we have 5x take away 2x is going to give us 3x. So because it's positive, that'll be plus 3x. And then on its own, all at the end, we have this constant term of just positive 7. So right at the end of this expression, we would have plus 7. And that's the final answer. Right then, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please leave a like. If there's any specific topics you can think of that you'd like me to go through next, please leave them in the comments. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.